I would like to request Nayan Bhai to please come up on the stage, and a very young entrepreneur developer Tejas Vyas to please come up on the stage, please. This is our 31st session where we are interacting with entrepreneurs who are from different walks of life. So we have got two stalwarts from the real estate industry. Nayan Bhai, everybody knows, that's the huge well-known brand in Mumbai called Mayfair. Tejas is a fantastic young next-gen entrepreneur who has got a product and a brand called Oyster Living. So let's start having an interaction with them. Nayan Bhai has been into the business, the house is into business for more than 50 years. He is actively involved in business for more than 35 years. He has developed a lot of houses across the state and I think a couple of more cities, and internationally also is into development. Tejas is a second generation entrepreneur taking into the footsteps of his father, who was developing a lot of projects between Dahisar to Virar and beyond. And due to his ailing health, Tejas stepped in, took it over from him, and today is a very enterprising entrepreneur. So we have got a current gen entrepreneur, we have got a next gen entrepreneur. On similar questions, what are their mindsets is what we are going to understand and take home from the evening today. So I'll begin with the legend Nayan Bhai. He is not only an entrepreneur, but he is also an Iron Man. I don't know how many of you people know what is the concept of Iron Man. Iron Man is, if you can explain it in a statement.
That's okay. It's a triathlon, so it's swimming, cycling and running all together. So
how many hours?
It was a 224-kilometer race, and to be finished within 17 hours. And I could do it in 16 hours, 22 minutes.
Fantastic. So I just wanted to give you that introduction just for you to realize that it's a powerful Iron Man on the stage tonight. And we will extract whatever he has achieved in his line as a businessman. So you just changed your logo. I saw your logo being unveiled today by Gautam Chatterjee and Suzanne Khan. What, according to you, does your logo stand for? What is the importance of it?
Thank you, Rajesh, for doing this session. And before I come to the logo and all that, I would like to start to say that I came into real estate only because of one reason. And you all will find this very, very surprising. Me and my elder brother, we are the two siblings from my parents. So my elder brother, my dad sent him to do post-graduation in civil engineering. And, you know, once in 1970s, 80s, when people go to USA, then the chances of their coming back is very, very less. So, you know, I told to myself that I want to live with my parents. So the only way I could live with my parents was to join my father. So honestly, I came to real estate business by coincidence because I wanted to live with my parents. So this is what I would like to begin with to say.
Okay. So Nayan Bhai, the objective of our session is going to be anecdotes of your decision making.
Right.
So that the entrepreneurs who learn from your decision making capabilities will implement them in their businesses and become a better entrepreneur.
Right.
So the reason for asking you, why did you change your logo and what do you think about the logo?
Right.
So we will, what the objective should be, Tejas and Nayan Bhai, is we will ask short questions and short answers so that we can cover a lot of topics.
Right.
Yeah.
So our brand line is appreciating you. And the triangle covers four colors: earth, air, water, and sun. So what we are saying is that we are, a developer is always wedded to nature. That's why the four colors, that's why the triangle. That's where the motivation comes from.
Why did you change it now?
Because we felt that after Narendra Modi's governance, the entire spectrum of corporate governance has changed. And appreciating you are the two words in which we are trying to tell the whole world that we love you, we appreciate your relationship, and if you were to become my customer, the value of your home will appreciate.
Tejas, what do you mean by a brand? What does the word brand sound of to you as an entrepreneur?
See, because I am from a background of real estate, I somehow feel that real estate brand as a subject is yet to evolve in our industry. And I feel somebody who has been there for 30-40 years delivered some some amount of like 40, 50 lakh square feet can be termed as a brand. Rest all, I think, is an evolution of marketing, which time and again will come and fade. So, because real estate is a highly, you look at it, a very long-term business. I take a decision today, it's like, sometimes it is even, bad than marriage. You take a decision and you live with it for 5, 7, 10 years, the same decision, within which you take 20 more decisions, but that one decision of taking a plot or not, or taking a, so I think branding is a very serious subject in real estate, and it is yet to be evolved as a subject for us developers and other stakeholders. I think it's a very large concept. I mean, if you look at Hindustan Lever, you can other brands, they are there since 100 years. I think branding has to be looked at from that angle, that how many years they have been there, done that, kind of a thing.
In your line of business, what are your core actions going to be in terms of the process of brand building for your brand?
Very simple. I look at the whole aspect from two things. One is what my dad taught me is, if you can build homes for people who cannot buy it, then stay in this business. So I believe that if you, and people talk about scaling up, I think the only way to scale up is you create a purpose of your life which is larger than your own self. And if you connect yourself to that, that's the only way to scale up. That's
how do you
thing.
Ensure that what you're talking happens on the ground?
What we're actually doing is I'm putting a lot of effort. I'm a civil engineer. I've spent my life 4 to 5 years on site. I have seen every single corner, right from the material dumping to material selection to testing and to concreting and to checking the formwork to everything. We've done, standing in the heat of the sun and doing it yourself. What we're doing it is that we're trying to pass on the philosophy in terms of training, repeated hammering with my team. So I think once the core changes of people, the way they look at it, the customer. So I look at it with the customers with a lot of empathy and not as a fruit. I look at it as an empathy. So what I do on ground is we have a meeting every day, every Monday for 4 hours with training session that I take with an entire organization. So the heart and soul of the organization, the DNA of the organization goes to the, even to the office boy, to the driver, to everybody. So that's how I would.
So Nayan bhai, you believed in transparency much before RERA came into the picture and all the other acts came into the picture. You were one of the first guys in Mumbai or probably in India who started selling by the concept of the carpet area that the customer is going to buy. What are the differentiators between you and the other players in the same industry in terms of customer management?
Number one, complete transparency. Delivery of the product on the date time. Number three, treating your customer really as your God. I have my customer over here, Mr. Gurshanani, so he knows about it. So for me, and I tell my son, my wife, my mom and my staff, ke inhone ghar kharida na, to tere ko pagar mil saka. इन्होंने घर खरीदा तो मेरा घर चल रहा है इन्होंने घर खरीदा तो मेरी कंपनी चलती है सो हाउ डू यू मैनेज इन अ वेरी सिंपल वे इन अ वेरी सिंपल कम्युनिकेशन टू योर पीपल आई टेल द पीपल फ्रॉम नार कि माय डैड स्टार्टेड एज अ रियल एस्टेट एजेंट ब्रोकर बिल्डर को करोड़पति कर सकता है और ब्रोकर बिल्डर को सड़कपति कर सकता है
How do you adapt to the changes in the industry? Every industry is always volatile at all times, especially in a developing country like India. So when a change happens, what are your strategies to adapt to those changes, like the current changes which have happened, like GST, demonetization, RERA? How do you adapt to those changes and how fast are you? For people who don't know, the first developer to be registered under RERA in this whole country is Mr. Nayan Shah for Mayfair. And that was quite a record which even surprised Gautam Chatterjee, because he did it at 12 o'clock or 1 o'clock in the night. I'm sure he was pre-planned for getting that done. So how quick do you adapt to the changes that happens in the environment?
See, Rajesh, there is an inner part of a company and there is an outside part of the company. I think the inner part of the company has remained the same in the last 53 years. Being true to your stakeholders, appreciating, respecting, loving, giving regards, making your project lovable, likable, enjoyable, beautiful. This is the inner part of Mayfair. This inner part of Mayfair, I think, has never changed and will never change also.
What do you do to make sure that whatever is thought by you and decided by you is also done by the people at the lower rung of your organization?
Very simple, Rajesh. It's very simple. we have to take up only one, two or three things that you have to talk to your staff. When you come with a list of 20 things to do, they get surprised ke boss ko priority kya hai, company ka priority kya hai. So I am very clear, customer agar aapke paas aata hai to usse shuru karo ki tere ghar ki chavi tujhe kis din milegi. Very simple. And I tell you ke the day I started announcing the day, that was the easiest day of my life. Kyun main ghar pe jaake aaram se so gaya, mere sare team kaam karne lage, are boss ne to announce kar diya hai, abhi to uski izzat aur company ki izzat daav pe hai, hum sab kuch karenge ke uske ek ghante pehle delivery de.
He has put up a board on all his sides where it goes diminishing by the day on the date of delivery. Do you still do that?
Yeah, we still do that.
So it is a pressure mounting tactic on your subordinates.
Yeah, and it puts everybody together. See, when John F. Kennedy announced that we will put a man on the moon in the next 10 years, the entire country only had one goal. So you know, every entrepreneur has to think of that one single goal. And if you can think of that one single goal, which is difficult, you can take the entire organization, the entire industry. Say for example, carpet area, everybody started carpet area. Box pricing, everybody started box pricing. Transparency, everybody started transparency. So you know, you have to think of that one thing. And the moment you think of that one thing and see, is it good for you? Everybody follows.
So Tejas, how do you be a differentiator in the industry that you are in? How would you want the people to differentiate you from what you do compared to what the others do in the same industry?
Well, what we have done recently is with a sea of change of things that have happened in the last 1 year, what we are trying to, so I was having a problem with my phone and I tend to write a Twitter to Vodafone. I don't call Vodafone, I tweet them and they immediately call back. And I got the response mechanism. There was somebody who heard my grievances. I shouted, I yelled, whatever I did. And then eventually they convinced me what I'm supposed to, and somehow my problems were resolved. I realized that there is no concept of client servicing or customer servicing in real estate. It's either sales or back office, or it is site, or it is finance or accounts. A customer service department was somewhere missing. The same, either the sales people in a crisis situation or the CRM or the back office used to manage the. So what I did was I hired people from such background and created a customer service department, which is actually directly reporting to me with a separate email ID from the customers to me. So now we are sending SMSs every day to the customers. We are calling those projects which are delayed and to call all the customers and give them a feedback that delayed by so-and-so date. And anybody who wish to meet me, I am available to meet them. So I have kept a target of people to them saying that at least 10 people should meet me a week. Rather than, you know, giving a target that they should not meet me, I did it reverse, let me meet them. Because customer can be the best feedback mechanism you can have to improve yourself. See, we are a very nascent, small and young organization. I am probably the eldermost in the entire company.
What is the mechanism that you have for your customer feedback?
That's what I'm saying. 3 times a day, each customer receives an SMS for the this thing. And all the projects that are delayed, they have a weekly target to call every customer. There is a complaint or an issue or a question or a query that is pending. Within 7 days, that department has to close it and send it to me. Every week, we do reconciliation of whatever has been pending. The customer is called back and told that we have been pending and we'll take more 3 more days or 4 more days. That's how we do it. And those customers who cannot get satisfied by any of them, I am willing open. So I have an open door policy. Anybody can come and meet me. It's a pretty transparent way. You know, people come and meet me without appointment. There's nothing like that. So even if I have to work till 10, 12, whatever at night. So I keep it very open to learn from the customers as a feedback. And there are several things customers have told me and I realized that ye toh maine kabhi becha hi nahi, lekin unhone ye dekh ke khareed liya. I mean, I can even realize ki acha, I could have sold this also, like in my own project. So these are the things which come as this thing. So, but I am not looking at from that perspective. I'm looking at that a customer deserves an answer and his money is there in my account. So I am answerable and I obviously they deserve an answer and I'm supposed to stand there and deliver an answer.
Delegation happens in your organization like in every other organization. How do you do it differently in your organization?
Very simple, Rajesh. To begin with, the person who meets the customer is the owner of the company. And that's absolutely clear in my organization. That's rule number one. That's rule number two. And that's rule number three. Very simple. The guy who meets the customer is the owner of the company.
So you delegate only responsibility or you also empower him with authority?
Absolute authority. When, once in a while, honestly, I don't have a customer service department. I tell the entire company is the customer service department. And I am the head of the customer service. Point number two, when any guy calls up saying, hey, sir, ye leakage hua hai or anything. So I tell my engineer, yaar ek baat bata, ye ghar teri behan ne agar kharida hota aur leakage hai, to tujhe kaisa lagta company ke liye?
So you are a very philosophical entrepreneur.
So I tell
you. You get into philosophy or giving examples to your team.
Yes. So I said ke, to tu kya karega? Tu thuk patti karke 6 mahine ke baad tu apun chale jane wale wo karega? Ya aise kaam karega ke 10 saal tak complaint nahi aayegi? Then he pauses and says, sir, main dusra karunga. Main to yahi samajh ke teri behan ne liya hai. Ye mat soch, hum leaking roof ka paisa nahi le sakte. Hum kharab title ka paisa nahi le sakte. Jo chahiye, we have to deliver him a clear, marketable title, well constructed home. Ye standard hai. Ab iske andar sab aa gaya.
Pricing is a very challenging subject in every industry. If you price it high, you don't sell. If you price it low, you're cutting on your profits. How do you arrive at pricing on a launch of a particular project?
I have a different philosophy to pricing. My dad was a salesman of years and years to go. I mean, my dad was in real estate since 79, 77. So, and he was a very, very strong salesperson and heading company like Ajmera in sales. So, I feel that, it is not me who decides the pricing. It is not the customer. It's the price at which it sells. It is very important, and it is very important to find that out. So at times it happens that, I am making a very dream project with a lot of amenities, I am giving so many things, it's a high rise. And I kind of get into the I can't say ego, but get into the euphoria of the project and then price it that way. But I somehow believe that neither the location, nothing. What derives the pricing is the price that it sells. And that is the key point. Price at its sales. If it will not sell, then any price, whatever I am giving a marble, an Italian marble, whatever I am doing, I am branding it, I am using Amitabh Bachchan, whatever I am using. But because real estate, see, frankly today, see, we are always underpriced. We are always 10-15% underpriced. What we did 2 years back, people came and told me, yaar, Vasai mein flat nahi bik rahe, tu Daisar mein Ubao mein bech rahe. We were doing pre-launch, yes, and there were sections who believed us and sections who did not believe us. But strongly we sold it. Today, after bearing all the load of the finances, bearing the load of the loans on them, now the builders are coming up and reducing the price by 20%, which we did already 2 years back. We gave the price benefit to the customer. I somehow believe that a customer and us are not on the opposite side. If we treat them right, price them right, we can together face the world and whatever the difficult time that we call, it's like a one team if we can create. We can just have to shift them to our side of the table and we can together go and face the challenges that we are talking about. So this one, price, one bit is not important, whether the location will derive the price or the padosi will derive the price. What will derive the price is, whatever it is, aaj ke socio-economical scenario in today's world, will it sell? At what price it will sell, it is very important.
How do you decide profitability in your project 9 by? Suppose if a project is costing you 100 rupees, you have got a fixed margin of profit, say 30%. So your gross revenue should be 130. But the market scenario over there can allow you a price point of 150. In such a situation, what will you do? What will you price the product?
First of all, Rajesh, we never sell real estate. We only help people to buy a home. I think that's a very fundamental philosophy we follow. Because each of you, when you come to buy a home, your research is far more than what I can ever do. So I can only help you buy.
Sometimes as a developer, you might strike a great deal where the most important component of a real estate in Mumbai is the land price. And you have strike a great deal. And I want to understand your mindset, whether you're a fixed profitability entrepreneur or you fluctuate according to the opportunity that you get. Suppose if you can, the market demands a price where you can make 150 rupees as profits. But on 100 rupees, even at selling 130 rupees, the customer benefits and you still make the amount of profit that you are generally used to be making in a project. What is the decision that you will take?
To be very true to you, until now, our idea was to make the maximum profit. So, if I bought at 100, 130, I'm happy. But I can sell at 160. I used to sell at 165. But now I think if we want to really scale up, then we'll have to think of selling not at 130, but at 125.
Is this the new market which has taught you this lesson, or you learnt it overall?
No, I think overall and the new market both together.
Both together.
Yes.
Tejas, what would you do in such a scenario?
As far as the land goes, I am a very gut feeling land buyer. To be honest, recently I have taken a stalled redevelopment project of another builder, and in that I am not making any money. You know, some friend's project I took over, I met the tenants who were staying before. I got emotional about their condition because of the delayed project. I met the buyers and I got further emotional. And I thought that if zindagi mein har decision paise ke liye nahi hota hai. So yeah, I take certain decisions which are close to my heart, which my spirit allows me to do. So, and I take such decisions and I move on. Pluses or minuses will go on tomorrow. So I don't look at that.
What does technology mean to you, Nayan bhai, and how do you use it to your advantage? And what is the kind of technology that you use in a construction?
Rajesh, the kind of development that happens in Mumbai and MMR, I think technology has a very limited role to play for a developer. Because we are into redevelopment or 5 acres, 10 acres development. But what has technology changed is in terms of customer service and customer approach and getting the leads. Digital technology has completed that mobile phone has changed the way of life for all of us. So number one, we are using it to the hilt. And the backward integration technology upgradation will come, as I told you in the previous session, when we will start developing 50, 100, 200 acres layout.
So Tejas, how do you use technology for executing your projects? And what are your views about the latest new technologies which are coming up, like prefab, precast, assembling the projects on the site, putting up a setup at the site itself to make it faster, cheaper, better quality? What are your views on that?
Yeah, so at Nayan bhai said there are two sides to technology. One is the construction and another is the digital technology for the other purposes of real estate. I think as far as technology goes, it is associated to scaling, to the scale of the project. If I'm using any modern technology, any formwork which is of modernized systems, I think a scale is very important to get it, to make it affordable or to make it sense to use it. Now what has happened is the speed. So I know I met a couple of Chinese developers, and if I say 100 acres, they said they will deliver those 100 acres in like 3 years. My question was 100 acres means XX number of houses. Will I able to sell them? So, you know, there is another aspect to it. Today we need lesser price in a bad market, but for lesser price, then again, you cannot match. You know, in a morning, some journalists were talking to me about a developer and image of developer. I think real estate is not a business. It is associated to a social, economical, environment that we are living in. Whenever we talk about real estate, we only talk about buyer and the builder. But we are discarding the entire social consideration, economical consideration that we right now dwell into. So if I use technology, cut down the price, my buildings will come on time, but there is no sales. So, and tomorrow when there is a sale, so it's like when you are doing it. And today if I start my project for 4 years, after 3 years, the market is going to change. So it's like the real, this decision. So that is why the traditional and conventional construction has been continuing in two slabs or three slabs or one slab per month is still going on with brickwork or blockwork. Max, you know, that has been continued. Max, I have seen aluminum centering, like Maiwan has come in. I have myself worked in Maiwan when I was doing a site work after my engineering. But other than that, I have not seen much exploration in terms of technology and construction. As far as marketing goes, I think there is, we are like in 1975, as far as real estate goes, even in India, compared to India, as far as digital age and marketing goes, I think what we started UID today is going to kind of transform real estate marketing in the coming years. And we will see how it does that. So like I read one article, Geo is actually a reverse of oil, where data is the new oil, and you know, everybody's going to churn that data. Success of MCH exhibition, sometimes I say, last year's data, I sold a flat 2 days back in Mira Road, where I participated a year back. That's the power of the data. We use it for once, we get 10% out of it, 90% goes in our Excel sheet somewhere drying in the drain. So, you know, it's an altogether different approach required to see real estate marketing. I think I think in times where young digital marketing entrepreneurs have come up and they're doing amazing job. I think there's a lot to learn every moment and you should keep learning every day. So
my last question after this, the house will open up for questions. My last question is, advertising impacts the price of a product. And being in the retail industry, you need to keep advertising so that people come to know about your project. Between the project cost, how do you balance that?
I have a different view on that.
I saw your full page ads few days back.
Yeah, a little different view on selling. Real estate is all about word of mouth. What my customers tell about me is more important than a full page ad or a brand ambassador.
But that is homeopathic treatment. You have got too many projects, then you'll have too few customers to sell that kind of stock.
So when I take a long-term view, Rajesh, I look at what is my customer satisfaction level index. And believe me, you, if you focus on customer satisfaction, in the last 3 years also, where people have gone to channel partners, and I have nothing against channel partners, sorry, I'm just saying, 60% of the sales in Mayfair has happened by references and by side dressages. And I just can't believe it. It's just the happy customer somehow or other pulls somebody and gets you down there. And advertising can be used as a medium to brand building. See, advertising and brand building always has to go. Look at Loda.
You define it with a percentage for the revenue of a project?
It's
3%, 4%, 5%.
It will be on the total corporate sales. So let's say that if a builder is doing 300 crores of sales, I would say that about 5 to 6 crores he should keep aside only for advertising and brand building.
Tejas, what is your take on that?
So as far as advertising goes, I think we still to evolve a lot of subjects in terms of marketing. There are several vertical horizontal layers. See, one is when you see any other industry, they come up with a positioning. And after building the positioning, and they build on that. For example, Maruti now sells as a Nexa. It's a positioning difference. They are selling Baleno in different shapes with a new brand, if you see. So it's still to happen in real estate, because real estate has a principle that each structure is unique and each structure is built inside to the first principle of real estate. So which is why it makes it a little difficult to position myself. In Kandivali, I position myself as a middle class. In Daisar, I position myself as lower middle class. In Kalyana, myself further. So it becomes slightly difficult for as a brand to, how to identify opportunity. Many of them, like Loda, you said, have done that job by creating a position for itself. And then once you position your brand, basis that you can build on that. Where you will churn the multiplication of your positioning by advertising. In today, what most of us have done wrong is following them. I have given my full page ad. That I think is with the market going little down has changed. Now people are working very, very keenly. How much percentage I got response on print? How much I got on radio? How much I got on recall? People are working on this detail. I said as if you are doing site work na, kitna cement aaya, kitna gaya, utna detail mein hota hai. I think marketing has now should take that shape in real estate to get the maximum out of it. I think today we are spending little over the return that we are getting. This little oversell is happening. Second, I have in 1980s, 1990s, in 1992 when India went out of the World Cup, then next day logo ne bola ki India jeet gaya kyunki do match mein kuch drugs khaya tha, ye tha, aisa kuch nikla tha. So now we are in semi-final. Then we saw the news and we saw ki aisa kuch nahi tha. Pehle log baat karte the, lekin hum bolte the ki news sunke ya medium sunke hum bharosa karte the. Aaj ulta hai. Today the whole marketing is about P2P. If you see even film industry, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, only somebody tells somebody a movie acha and people go.
But how do you plan your budget? These are all good strategies.
Yeah.
How do you plan it?
So
the project is 50 crores. How do you plan your spend on that?
So I have kept a basic figure that 50% it should be sold by channel partners and 50% my team has to sell is what we believe. And approximately 2 to 3% is what we keep as a budget where we can...
That budget is monitored.
That budget is monitored every day.
Lovely, lovely. So friends, you can start asking questions that you want them to get answered, which might help you in your business. Yes, Rohit, can we roll around the mics pretty quick because we'll finish this in 15 minutes.
My question too is, Nayan bhai. So it's absolutely commendable that you know declare the possession date. Now, the practical question is, see, you can declare the possession date, and there are many builders who would like to declare the possession date, but there are a lot of factors which are uncontrollable. So with that, if the the schedule is overrun of your, you can't match the date. So how do you handle the customer? Or do you all the time able to match your possession date?
Rohit. See, a relationship between a customer and a developer depends upon what attitude and approach you have.
Right.
If you have booked a flat with Mayfair, and I promised you possession on Sunday, 31st December 2017 at 11 a.m. Assuming you come at 11 a.m., you see the building ready, you see your flat ready, but the OC has not come.
That is what happens.
Right? But at least you will give the benefit of doubt to Mayfair. That Mayfair ne mera paisa leke aur kahin nahi dala. Building to ready kar diya. Shayad approval mein koi, matlab OC mein koi issue hai, wo BMC officer available nahi hai, wagere wagere. So I think that out of the 14 projects that we did this, we failed in 5 of them or 4 of them. But in each of them, Rohit, you will not believe, I didn't have a single phone call from a developer shouting at us, nor shouting at our salesman, nor creating
any ruckus.
Kuch nahi, ab tak koi notice bhi nahi hai. Kyunki maine to clearly ek saal pehle bol diya tha, aapko 11 baje dene wala hoon. Aur aapko chavi diya hai, maine to 30 mai ko, to 90 days to mera delay clear dikhta hai. Kisi ne kuch nahi kiya. They all said, ke we know you have done your best. So what the industry expects is to do the best for the customer.
It has to be in your spirit.
Your attitude and approach should be that I respect you, I regard you, and I know that because of your money, my survival is there. Aaj main yahan kis wajah se baitha hoon? Aapki wajah se. Aaj mujhe inhone yahan kyun bataya? Aapki wajah se. Wo cheez jab main bhul jaunga na, tab main yahan baithunga, par aapki respect nahi hogi aapki.
Do you create a buffer when calculating the delivery date in the schedules? Do you create a buffer?
Yes, we have our 60-day, 90-day buffer, you know, into this. Obviously, that has to be built. Because the beauty is to give you 30 days before. And that's where the buffer is.
Next question, please. We'll be taking 5 more questions.
As we know that the cost of the construction, cost of the building is basically because of the land and because of the approval. As said in the earlier thing, the land, we have got a very brilliant idea from Rajesh that JV is one of the solution. For the approvals, like with government, if you have the stipulated time may they give you, you should be getting whatever service you have asked. If similarly, that same formula can be applied, like you apply online, these are the formalities you wanted, I have given it online. Within 10 days, I should be getting the whatever CC or in between for a completion of first plinth, I get the permission. If we can think in that way. And the third thing is, like 30, 40 years ago, buying a house was not that difficult. Paisa collect kiya, achha builder dhunda, usko diya, mera ghar mila, I was happy. It's not the same thing last 15, 20 years for various reasons. Can we all think seriously on that why this has happened and try to find a solution for that? Thank
the
you.
The budgeting of the house is what she's meaning at.
Sorry?
Budgeting of the housing is what she's meaning
right.
at.
Madam, you have asked very fundamental questions. So, I may not reply to you in the manner in which you have asked. But I think this government, both at the central level and at the state level, have done 2 things. At the central level, Mahar era has come. So what Mahar era has tried to do, it has tried to bring that very philosophy that you said 40 years back, ke jab aap bharosa karte the, to inhone kya kiya, bharose ko ek law mein badal diya. Very simple. Ke jo bhi project mein karta hoon, to wahan pe kareeb 25 questions puche hain Mahar era ki website pe. उसका जवाब अगर मैं प्रॉपर देता हूँ, जैसे मुझे चाय बनानी हो तो पानी कितना गर्म है तो इतना गर्म है, चीनी कितनी थी तो इतनी डाली, फिर चाय की पत्ती कितनी डाली, फिर ये कितना डाला, तो ये 5 स्टेप उसने बराबर किया तो अच्छी चाय बनने ही वाली है. पहले कैसे था, आदमी को आदत थी. तो सेम वे सेंटर और स्टेट ने जब महार एरा लाने से वो एक ट्रस्ट उन्होंने क्रिएट करने की कोशिश की है और वो जरूर होगी अभी. सो दैट्स पॉइंट नंबर वन. पॉइंट नंबर टू रिगार्डिंग द गवर्नमेंट इनिशिएटिंग के उनके भी जवाबदारी आए, तो ये सीएम ने महाराष्ट्र के देवेंद्र फडणवीस जी ने एक नया कायदा निकाला जिसका नाम है राइट टू सर्विसेज एक्ट. राइट टू सर्विसेज एक्ट इन्होंने में तीन चीज डाली कि अगर तेजस भाई अप्लाई करते हैं तो विद इन 30 डेज उनको आईओडी मिलनी चाहिए. नहीं देनी है तो ऑफिसर को रिप्लाई देना पड़ेगा कि क्यों वो आईओडी नहीं दे रहे हैं. अगर उनके पास आईओडी है और वो कंप्लाई किया है तो उनको 9 दिन में सीसी मिलनी चाहिए. अगर वो नहीं करता है तो उसको दंड लगेगा, उसका प्रमोशन रुकेगा. और तीसरी कि अगर तेजस भाई ने बिल्डिंग कंप्लीट की और अप्लाई किया तो 30 दिन में उसको उसी मिलना ही चाहिए. तो ये होने से अभी जैसे बिल्डर को एक कंपल्शन आ गई, वैसे ही प्लानिंग अथॉरिटी को भी कंपल्शन आ गई है कि उनको ये टाइम पे देना ही चाहिए.
व्हाट आर योर क्विक कमेंट्स ऑन दैट?
So I think what he says is absolutely right. In one of the cases of my friend where the building is ready and the OC has not come, like normal cases, I think over the period of time you will see more cases of that sort where the, you know, where the approval thing will come in the light, where right now everybody discussing where the developers are delayed slowly even that. So the public pressure will now then shift on, and the demand on the the service from the government side is going to increase. It's a change that is we are looking at. I think in the next 2 years you will see that happening really quickly once things come out of on the surface. So things came out on the surface since few years that developers have not delivering. So now people have started focusing on delivery. They have reduced their exposure. Now same way, the same pressure will come on the government and the authorities. And I think in the next 2 years you are going to see the change what we are expecting. Second, in the old days, Bharosa Tha, I'll tell you, agar Nayan Bhai is a very old company and he'll tell me that a 7 malle ka building wo log 4-5 saal mein deliver karte the, tabhi hamara expectation bhi nahi tha. Abhi wo hum main bata bahut kuch socially bhi connected hota hai. 1965 mein kisi ko ye bharosa nahi tha ki 3 saal mein ghar milega. They were waiting at 7-8 years, humne book kara ke rakha hai aur bhul. Telephone my family waited for 10 years. So utna hamara expectation bhi nahi tha. Abhi humne expectation badhaya fir abhi humne usko delay kiya. So I think somewhere there is a balance which will strike. With RERA coming in, we will put a safer date to the play and all that will happen. So, life has become fast, that construction will take the same time.
Please don't ask questions related to the real estate industry. My request is ask questions related to entrepreneurship. Can I have more questions before we wind up? Questions related to business. Yes, Sudha. Real estate ka dose ho chuka hai pichle do panel discussions mein.
Yeah, I don't want to discuss that at all. I have questions for both of them, so they can answer independently. What is that inspires you every single day, in spite of challenges, circumstances, people? Managing people is the biggest challenging. People say there's a saying that you don't manage a business, you manage people. So you come from a different thought of school. You come from a different thought of school. What is that keeps you going every single day in spite of challenges around you, be it people, reforms, circumstances, family, health, personal issues, mental attitude, everything?
And the frequency of demonetization, GST, RERA, yeah, all happening
not,
together.
Not
what
to just
keeps
miss
you inspired?
That. Not to just miss that, because a younger generation like me have a very different answer to it. Maybe someone like you will have a very different answer to it. So I just want to know both of you. Guys, where do you come from? Where do you get this motivation on daily basis to keep going, irrespective?
Who wants to go first?
I'll say that. Okay. So I was waiting for somebody to ask such genuine question in terms of entrepreneurship. So I'll tell you one thing. One personal experience I would like to share is like, it's very close to my heart. Very less number of people would know. 4 years back, I was under depression and genuinely under medication. And somewhere I found out and I found some spiritual direction, and right now also I do all my business in the sense through spirituality and those principles. And somewhere I realized and I said that when you connect yourself with a purpose which is larger than yourself, okay, then the self is out. If you understand that language, I'll say then the self is out. Then the pain is not there because it is happening to a person which is insignificant to the purpose. I have told myself, and from my side, I'm saying, I will not hang my boots or I will not die before delivering 10,000 keys to people. So that's what my philosophy and the purpose that I generated from where I actually could come out of that dark period of my life with this purpose of my life, 10,000 homes to 10,000 families. I'm not going to retire. I'm not going to die. That keeps me going every single day with all the pain.
Is it the key for the satisfaction of the buyer or the money behind the key?
I think I have already told that give house to those people who cannot buy one. My dad keeps telling me that and I keep repeating that.
That's fantastic statement. Rajesh, that's fantastic statement. If we can address that same question and then you can ask it. Yeah. Yes. What inspires you?
Yeah. As our brand line says, appreciating you. I think I've tried to summarize my life into these two words only. Appreciating you. It's a very, what I look forward every day is to make a strong bond with my own self, because unless I don't see myself, who am I, what I want to do, what makes me happy, what makes me feel sad, unless I don't myself, I can never be an original guy. So I may differ with you, but so far as I can respect you, appreciate you and worked with you, so I think that lets me going every day, and that is able to keep my mood equanimous, whether it's the municipal official who doesn't do my file, or whether it is that customer who comes and buy my flat. For me, both the moments are the same, because I am appreciating him.
What is your biggest inspiration?
And one goal that I have kept in my life, just as he said, that before I die, I want to see that every person in Mumbai metropolitan region has a quality, affordable home for himself. This is the larger goal that I have.
Yes, gentlemen.
I have one question for entrepreneurship and one for real estate, if you can allow me. For entrepreneurship, which are the most three important ingredients which makes you successful entrepreneur? And for real estate, do you think the moment developer registered his or her projects in RERA, from consumer's perspective, it is absolutely safe, number one. Number two, for developers, it is the project which they registered. Why can't government come out with a license system for developers' company? Because there can be a developer who has got five different projects and he is registering each project in different RERA registration. And if anything goes wrong with one project, other four projects are not disturbed. According to me, entire company should be responsible. Okay. Yes.
So you answer the business question.
The real estate one.
Real estate one. And you answer the business one.
So I'll tell you one thing, as I said, that I was taught in engineering, one of the construction management subject, that each structure, first principle, sir. And real estate is not a toothpaste. Okay. So you get a toothpaste and some malfunction happens in Indore. They take off the supply of the entire India. It's not like that. They are life associated to that. If something goes, and it's a business decision, mind you, I'll tell you, people's life decisions have gone wrong. Okay, your and my life decisions have gone wrong. A business decision can go wrong at one place. There are other places where life is associated to, which is why RERA associated to project-wise makes a lot of sense. Other than what you said was that whether it is safe once it's registered. What I'm saying is that if you ask a developer, other than now everything is like a document and XYZ, other if you ask a developer and you yourself know you've met so many, 95% of the people, and I'm telling you 95, I give you in writing the number of people you know and I can compare and get a percentage of 95 that wants to stand up and deliver. They don't like undelivered projects. They don't sleep well. 5%, you know, I think any industry can have a discard, and we should not judge this 5% and 95% together. So in that regard, I think that without RERA, with my industry, I think people were already safe. With RERA, there is somebody is overlooking it about how I am working. I am more than happy somebody is checking me. Some big eye is checking me where I keep my line, you know, straight. I think it's a great thing coming up. The confidence has gone back strongly. with all, you know, one of the first stall here was there, and they've done a beautiful, you know, this stall there. Yaar, tune rehra bahut chota likha hua hai. Isa bada 2 foot ka panel maar hai, aur usme maharela likh de. You know, and then you see the footfall, and next day you remove it, and then see the footfall. I want to experiment. Can you do it? He said, I am ready to do it. He's going to put up tomorrow. I think if that is making a difference, what madam said, that, you know, bharosa tha, I think wo bharosa fir aa gaya hai. And we all should stop analyzing too much and focus on like one day job, complete that and go home, come back again, do that job and come back and keep doing that for years and years, and then definitely, you know, homes will be delivered on time. Rather than analyzing, over-analyzing a case, B case, C case, you know, so many, you know, how many projects got registered? 15,000? So 15,000 projects registered, 2 projects get stalled, and we rate the industry as bad or black or white. The industry that cooks, you know, makes food cook in your house and my house. I think our focus should be stop analyzing and keep working every day hard. Ensure that and I'm asking you, the buyer should also check us. When I took a stalled project of my friend, I went there and told the existing customers, don't trust me today. I am not going to give you sales talks. I have come here as a bridge. I'll make your building. Ek 3 mahina aur ruk jao. Reti cement wahan dikhega to bharosa karna nahi to mat karna. I think wo din aayenge jab log wapis bharosa karenge.
His question is whether if a builder has got 5 projects, he flaws in one.
I said no.
Can all those 5 be connected?
I said no.
He says no.
Lives are connected.
His view is no. My saying is yes. It brings the developer under more accountability. Nayan bhai, he wants to ask those 3 business questions to you. The right. 3 best decisions or strategies that you used in your life as an entrepreneur.
I'd like to reply about the RERA thing just for a minute before. Sir, there is only one principle in business that works. Appreciating you, and that's it. That's the only thing. There is no second thing. There is no third thing. Baki sab cheez aap seekh sakte ho. Strategy, this, that. Kyunki unless I don't respect the relationship that I have with you, unless I can't look into your eyes and talk to you, that's no business. So that's number one. So, yeah.
And the 3 successful strategies, he wants to use them.
Again,
quick,
the same,
3 successful ones.
Again, the same thing. Appreciating you, values and ethics. Usse alawa, matlab, mere ko aur koi cheez sochne mein aati nahi hai. Ke bhai second.
Who has devised this punchline for you, appreciating you?
Well, it just came up.
Is it yours, your son's or the agency?
Sorry. I think I must give complete credit to my son and to my entire team, you know, who said, ke, sir, this is what should be there. This is what is the backbone of Mayfair.
As Mayfair. Last questions, no,
one minute, 1 minute. I want to reply about the RERA thing.
Oh, okay.
Right. Please, into inverted commas. RERA is a great thing. But what I started hearing in the last 2 months, ke people saying ki abhi to RERA aa gaya na, to yahan pe samjho 10 jan randomly baithe hain, ha? To kiska ghar sabse sasta milta hai, main uske paas jaunga, kyunki sare RERA register hai. To mujhe phir, you know, let me not take names of any developer. So, main saste mein jaunga. I think this is the biggest myth. And this is my insight, and RERA is the biggest myth. Mujhe bataiye, all medicines are FDA approved. Do you buy the medicine which is the cheapest? All doctors have license to operate under medical council. Do you go to the cheapest doctor? All training institutes, why don't you? So, in my view, branding, execution, and performance, they have always remained the biggest gainer for a company to progress. RERA is just a hygiene. But agar mujhe really industry ka Bill Gates, Steve Jobs, Warren Buffett, Mukesh Ambani banna hai, to mujhe branding, execution, or performance. In 3 cheez to mujhe chahiye hi chahiye.
Most important question was, एक बिल्डर के 5 प्रोजेक्ट रजिस्टर्ड है, 4 में सक्सेसफुल है, 1 में फेल है. उसके 5 प्रोजेक्ट गवर्नमेंट ने अटकाने चाहिए या नहीं अटकाने चाहिए? यस और नो?
एब्सोल्युटली नॉट.
नॉट. ओके.
एब्सोल्युटली नॉट.
विनीत.
गुड इवनिंग
सर. टाटा सन्स की 4 कंपनी बैंकरप्ट हुई है, तो क्या टाटा सन्स बंद हो गई क्या?
विनीत.
गुड इवनिंग जेंटलमैन. माय क्वेश्चन इज,
for entrepreneurship, and both can answer this. One way of doing business is using a lot of logic, strategy, analysis, and another way of happening business is a lot of. What is your definition of business? How much is logic important and how much is magic important in business?
So, see, we have a lot of focus on perfection. Your question also was aiming at, you know, on achieving something perfect, something right, something like absolutely bang on, right? And I'll tell you, you will never achieve that. Neither the logic, neither the magic. What I look at is that you will never have a perfect life, but you will have, you can have a balanced life. You know, if you see the nature also, so everywhere you find a real answers to entrepreneurship, go to nature. Nature, nothing is perfect. Nothing is in symmetry, but everything is balanced. So your logic and magic, the balance of it at your own spiritual level, that will work for you.
And the third word,
in either of the cases.
And the third word is logic, magic and jugaad. Yes, Nayan bhai.
Well, looking back to life, because when you asked this question, I had to really think back. And I'm thanks that they just took up the question, because then I could think a little about how to reply. I think logic and magic, both can work. And there is only one word that can make that work, and that is passion. If you are passionate about doing anything, logic and magic will automatically follow.
So you are an entrepreneur who is a passion pruner.
Absolutely.
So you are not an entrepreneur, you are a passion pruner. You are pursuing Absolutely. Your passion.
Yes.
Fantastic. So friends, that was the end of the 31st session of Inspiring Conversations. I am sure both these wonderful gentlemen have shared loads of knowledge, some of which can be used by us, and we can become better entrepreneurs. I would like to request Suhani to bring up the mementos for our guest. I would like to request Devang Shah to come up and do the honors to Nayan Bhai. I would like to request Pradeep to come up on stage and do the honors to Tejas.